In the lands of Kolguyev, a strange army, a strange peasant revolt has started to rebel against the young chief Mandak of Kolguyev, and we must help him to make that not get out of control. Thankfully, our great king, or rather now Emperor Bragi, the soul of the All-Father, has finally managed to actually start building a fleet for Kuloy and the rest of the realm. And we're uniting that fleet at the moment. The retinues are coming. At full speed are they galloping towards the capital, towards the ships that will bring them to Kolguyev. We also have other things to do. We want to get better crown jewels, really expensive ones fit for an emperor. Also, there are some changes we can maybe make in the year of 1120. We'll see about that and more in the coming time. Let's go. See, we're uniting our ships. Here we go. Now let's wait for the 40 ships that are coming. Whoop. That's better. This is our spymaster, by the way. Our grandson and heir. His father died at a very, very young age. So, this, now, well, it seems like our big, big plans have come to an end, instantly, and we're now playing as Emperor Bragi the Fourth of Nenetsia, heir to the Jarldom of Livonia and Emperor of Nenetsia. But who hasn't got many kingdom titles anymore? We have a new heir, Stola Bragison, our tiny, tiny son. And what has happened to Bragi III? After completing his goal to be the first emperor of the Dovris, he now feasts in Valhalla. He really feasts as he has become fat. At age 63, he died a natural death, cursed with an unhealthy love for food. Bragi was known for his massive girth, and he had court for fearing that his habits would lead him to an untimely demise for years before his death. And we have lost some titles. The Kingdom of Nordericki goes to King Rikulf of Nordericki, uncle and son of King Bragi. Also, the county of Westerbotten goes over there. We have pretenders. We have a lot of pretenders. Emperor Bragi the Fourth. Having mastered many skills, he's sure to be admired by his subjects. Long live Emperor Bragi the Fourth. So be it. And now, we even have more problems. Let's see. We have this war that we had started, or that the Emperor Bragi the Fourth had started. Oh, it's a war that we must win or lose whatever we had. And it's not looking bad, as we can now call on many more allies than before. But let's remember now Bragi the Third. And in a new episode, we will start with everything to do for Bragi the Fourth. We'll also have a look now at Bragi the Fourth to get to know him before we remember the old man. So let's see. So we're a dutiful cleric, so we're not really that good of a cleric, but we're okay. We've had some learning. We are relatively good at intrigue. We are now focused on seduction at the moment. We already have an heir, a very young one, though, who doesn't really like us, we have to say. We have a good, beautiful wife. We're lustful, Uncoth. We are already scarred. The scar comes from a wound that we gained as the spymaster of Nenetsia, actually. We're gregarious, so we love people and probably love to celebrate feasts and fairies and all kinds of things. We are also paranoid, see enemies in every shadow, unable to trust anyone. We're militant, we have an increased personal combat skill and increased monthly prestige. That is our faith. We are also shrewd, so we have developed a sharp and astute mind, as you can see. There's a lot that is to live for. We want to kill Gurid Odrsdot here. Who is that? Who is that? The heir to the county of Onega. What? For whatever reason. Why would we kill an infant? Let's see, is there any reason for that? Or is that just an oddity? How old is she even? She's absolutely harmless. We really don't know what happened here. And I think it's probably not a good idea to stay with that plot. Well then, okay, so that's our character. And now let's remember our old man, not our parent, Bragi of Bjarmia, rather our grandfather, Emperor Bragi, the Sword of the Allfather, a really a legendary man. Can see here now from the score increase now. He also had a lot of money. We have now really a lot of money on our hands. We have a lot of counties and we need to distribute them as well. Bragi III, the Sword of the Allfather, had inherited a relatively small realm here in Nenetsia. He had gained a county here and there. He had inherited some things here and there. He had led some unsuccessful wars against Khazaria and some successful ones in this region. He was an avid man of faith, having converted many counties here to the Germanic faith that were before Suomenusko, in Tengri, Slavic. And through a stroke of luck, he had gained Nenetsia. But a two-front war was running and has managed to keep that intact and even expand the number of vassals he had to make Nenetsia truly a great empire. Oh, look. And we can, even now, send an offer to Chief Arnor the Whisperer to become a vassal of ours. The Chief of Nidaros, and we'll do that, of course. There's this Finnish man, there's Denmark here, a very small Denmark. We had our old man had prepared to kind of take Novgorod under his wings by swaying Queen Dobravi of Novgorod. But that is over now. We have other relations to care for. What was Bragi III also? He was an exceptionally great, great warrior. Now you can see he had Marshal 19, but he went nearly into the 30s. He was leading the Wolf Warriors. He was a very, very successful man. And his former Marshal, and now still our Marshal, is now the chief of the Wolf Warriors. Now we could join the Wolf Warriors as well, like our father, or rather our grandfather. Maybe it, though it is not the right way. Now, keep in mind, we're not really an evil character. We're paranoid, okay. We're lustful, okay, but these are not sins that lead us to usually kill people. Even in this case, it seems to be true. So the question is, would we join the Fellowship of Hell? That's the question. I think we'll be waiting if we do that. We could join the Wolf Warriors again, but we have no intention to do so. We're a dutiful cleric who is now dabbling in intrigue matters. And even if we have quite a good personal combat skill, we're no master of strategy. So let's see. This was, of course, a very, very short episode, but we will have to prepare now for the outlook of Bragi the Fourth of Manetia, his plans. We have seen his personality, his superficial connections. But what are his plans for the Empire of Manetia? What were his personal plans? He wants to acquire a title. Well, acquiring a title now is probably impossible to get a better title than that. He has, as you can see, quite acquired a lot of things. And I've come back to him as the heir to Bragi. He has, however, while being lustful, he has no concubine. So there's something also exciting coming up, right? Something exciting apart from looking into the strategy. There's more relations coming up. As for the religious people, some really like him. Some rather not. But all in all, we don't have bad relations. Don't have bad relations. There's something that we have personally, and that is Upland. And Upland is a really, really good county. And the question is really, if we should concentrate more on Scandinavia and leave Kuloy aside. We're of Norse culture, we're North Germanic. We have been the Jarl around here. The county of Upland. And we had the Jarldom of Swifjord, and maybe as we have grown up here, become a ruler here, maybe it would make sense to have that. And maybe even Orland, if we manage to get it for ourselves. And Upland is truly a great, great province, let me see. There's Hotuna, which of course now at the moment looted, but in theory it can be so much more. It is a temple, it has a city, And it has even three other spots we could have here. Could still be a build a hospital and a fort. There's a lot that speaks for it to be concentrated here, to concentrate our forces and just about everything here. Could offer this man vassalization, but he's a king. Okay. He won't do this. The question is if we would, could we lead a war against him? Probably not, because we have raised army levies now. Yeah, there's that. So it's fine, it's okay. What else would we do? We could compose a book already. We could commission a runestone, that makes sense, and search for a smith. Maybe not compose a book already. That's something that we'll do later in life and not right now. There is some laws that our grandfather wanted to change still, but he didn't live to that, and so... Oh, look at that. We only have supporters on the council. Well... yeah, for giving things to the council, okay. We must ourselves get enough supporters to be able to skew this in our favor, as our grandfather had masterfully done. And so, this is what we're looking forward to. Thankfully, our current council seems excellent. And our relations to them are really, really good. We are holding too many duchies, though. At least one, and we'll have to give them away. And that's the decision we'll have to make. Also connected to changing the capital. Will we give the Jarlum of Bjarmia away, maybe? Would that be something? And along with it, the counties of it. We could give it to our son. Would be unprotected then. But who could be already rich and powerful at a very young age. Could protect him though. And give that to someone else. Maybe a friend. Maybe another relative. Maybe our wife. Our wife would make a lot of sense, but she's a little bit different to us, even though she's also shrewd. The good Empress Gudrun. So there's a lot to consider, as you see. There's an exciting time coming for us. The new Emperor Bragi IV of Nenetsia. Thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. We'll see each other in the next episode. Starting, and that is exclusive, you said now, starting from a new episode 1, as we'll concentrate on every Emperor as a story for itself. We'll still keep the overwhelming playlist. But I see these now as exclusive stories. Story after story after story. Intertwined, connected, surely, but very important one after the other. And that's why I'm starting by one again. Looking at the time period will be one thing, comparing it to what happens in our game. And in general, that just very shortly, in general, make Make it just an overlook what is happening around the map, because I think there's some interesting things coming here. Also, with the Chinese emperors doing their best to get everything under control. So thank you for watching and happy gaming to you. This is Immanuel, signing out. See you soon, my friends.